Good morning, leaders. I just wanted to share something real quick with you out of my book, Heart of the Father. It's chapter 3 called Distracted. And I had a mentor. He used to say, had a saying all the time. He said, it does you absolutely no good to be in the right place at the right time if you lack the awareness that you're even there. That's what happens when we get distracted. And I just want to read you a couple things. The word distracted actually means to draw or direct one's attention to a different object or in different directions. In Latin, it actually means to draw or drag apart. And you know, when I allow myself to be distracted spiritually, I'm being drawn apart from the heart of the Father. When I allow myself to be distracted, I'm not fully paying attention, and I find myself being lackadaisical, haphazardly, and kind of just going through the motions. I'm not doing things with excellence, wasting the fullness of my time as well as my talent. That's what happens when we allow ourselves to be distracted. And ultimately, I miss out on the opportunity to partner with God in making an impact. This is what I really wanted to share from the book. It's actually in Acts 14. And in Acts 14, we see Paul is speaking to a group of people while at Lystra. And the scripture says that among the crowd was this man. And this man, he'd been lame from birth. And this man had never walked a day in his life. He sat there and he listened to Paul as Paul was preaching. And it says that Paul looked at this dude, said it looked at him, and saw that he had faith to be healed. Now, I want you to just kind of put that right back here. It said that he saw, Paul's looking out there, he sees this guy's got faith to be healed. So Paul called the dude out and says, stand up on your feet. And at that moment, this guy who had never walked, he jumped to his feet and began to walk. And that man's whole world just changed like that, right there, right? As the kingdom of God came near. And the same loving Father who oversaw that miracle is working today, this day, and desires to make the same kind of impact in the lives of people today. Here's where I wanted to kind of talk about. Just want to look at this other aspect of this. It says, Paul, he's speaking to this crowd, right? He's saying words, he's speaking to this crowd, and he's gazing out over the crowd, but there's something about this man that piques his interest. And he notices, says he notices this man had faith to be healed. Paul could probably see with his physical eyes that the man had a disability, right? But how did he see that he had faith to be healed? Well, that's not observed with the physical plane. That's only observed on the spiritual plane through the help of the Holy Spirit. Paul was not only doing the Father's work, he was also connected to his heart and in step with the Holy Spirit. So he knew where God was working and could tell that this man had faith to be healed. That's amazing. We cannot clearly see where, when, what, or how God is working in the lives of other people if we are allowing ourselves to be spiritually distracted. People are groping for the Lord. That's what it says in Scripture. They are searching and feeling their way towards Him. And we have eyes to see and ears to hear in order to connect them to the one that their heart longs for. It's time to wake up, church, and make the impact we've been called to make. So, hey, I hope this has added value to you. I hope you stay connected, not distracted today. And again, just a little excerpt from a book, Heart of the Father, chapter 3 on distracted. Have a great day, and God bless.